There are four basic types of measurement you can take with these versatile tools. An outside measurement, here with the large jaws, an inside measurement with these smaller jaws on top, a shoulder measurement between these two ground surfaces, and a depth measurement using this bayonet or depth bar that extends out the back of the caliper. The most common, of course, will be between the large jaws here. This will usually be called an outside, external, or outside diameter measurement, depending on whether it's on a square or round part. Next most common is probably taking an internal measurement using these smaller jaws on top. Again, it could be between two square edges or on the inside of a round hole. Before we look at making these four types of measurements, remember to check that the caliper faces and the faces of the part you're measuring are clean and don't have any burrs. Either of these can change the readings you get significantly. When you're using either set of jaws, there are a couple things to keep in mind. Make sure the jaws engage squarely on the surfaces being measured, and that they aren't cocked to one side or at an angle. The more of the surface that you can engage with the jaws, the better. This measurement here will likely give you better accuracy and repeatability than this one here. If I'm just engaging the sharp tips and edges, it's hard to tell if I've got tilt this way or this way. As soon as I introduce an angle here, I'm changing how far the jaws spread apart, and of course, I'm changing the measurement displayed on the tool. When you're using calipers, you need to think about the amount of force your hand is exerting on the tool to ensure you aren't causing the tool to bend slightly and give you a bad reading. We aren't talking about enough force to damage the tool, just enough to deflect things very slightly and affect the measurement. If you're trying to measure features at the accuracy limit of the tool, which is about 1/1000th of an inch, it doesn't take much extra force to make your measurement accuracy questionable. Luckily, it doesn't take that long to get a feel for the right amount of force necessary when using these tools. You don't want to reef down on the thumb wheel. I like to think of the force as gentle yet firm. It's probably the easiest to start by measuring a square face block like this 1-2-3 block, or a gauge block if you have one. Here, these wide, flat, smooth faces give the caliper lots of engagement. So it's pretty easy to feel when the jaws are fully seated. I will shift the part I'm measuring between the jaws just a little bit until it feels like the jaws are fully engaged. It also makes it less likely to get deflection in the jaws the higher up you are on the jaws, since you don't have as long a lever to pivot around the workpiece. Another thing that's nice about an accurate block is you can check if the caliper is set correctly and also see how the pressure you're using influences the measurement. I know that this 1-2-3 block here is accurately ground to 1 inch thick along this side. So I can measure it repeatedly to check that my measurement repeats at exactly 1.000 inches on the dial. And this will also give me an idea of the pressure I should be using when taking the measurement. Another way to double check your readings using calipers is to grasp the jaws themselves between your fingers and seat the jaws against the part with no input from the thumb wheel. Now, the force to close the jaws is not going through the frame, but is directly through the jaws. So I'm assured of not having any deflection and extra motion in this area of the tool. The measurement I get doing this should be what I'm shooting for when I'm using the thumb wheel.